Escape the ordinary. Lumberjacks is Des Moines' downtown playground, featuring four unique concept bars, including Des Moines' largest whiskey bar and only year-round indoor patio. Enjoy throwing axes, listening to live music, shooting pool, or escaping from a chamber, all under one roof. For complete details, go to lumberjacks.com.
Hey guys, it's Rock Girl Sydney. I'm here to tell you a little bit about what it was like to audition for Rock Girl last year and make everybody feel a little more comfortable and encourage you to do so. So auditioning was honestly terrifying for me because it was way out of my comfort zone. I wasn't really terribly prepared either since I waited till the last second. So one of my recommendations would be if you want to audition, don't wait until the very last casting call. Just get it over with. There's not typically a ton of people at the first couple, and so go out there and get your face out there and make sure everybody gets to see you for a little while. But honestly, the casting calls are not that scary. You hang out with Moose for a little bit, and otherwise you hang out with the other Lazer staff who are honestly awesome. So I would just not be intimidated by the casting call and all the people who are there. Just go get it over with and at least pretend that you're super confident in what you're doing. Being in the top 10 was really fun. It was very exciting and very busy, but you got to know this group of girls who you may never have met, you know, any other opportunity. And not just the girls, but also all the different Lazer staff and some of the other people who were involved. It was a little weird to ask people to vote for you, but you kind of get over it pretty quickly, and everybody kind of works together to make sure everybody votes who you see at the different events and stuff like that. There are several things that I would qualify as my favorite part of being Rock Girl. A few of them would be definitely the shows. That's an obvious. Going to all the different shows, whether it's a concert or a comedy show. We even got to go to X Games this year. So all those things are obviously a huge selling point for me for favorites of being the Rock Girl. I love being on air with Andy on Fridays. That's one of my favorite things. I look forward to it every week. And outside of that, there are so many different things that I've had the opportunity to do, like make new connections here at Lazer. I've gone blonde, which is something I never anticipated doing. I think the connections and the different things you get to do, the different opportunities that you are given that you wouldn't have otherwise. My responsibilities as a Rock Girl, it's pretty flexible, which is really nice since I have a super busy schedule. But in terms of the responsibilities that I try to kind of keep up with, actually attending the events and promoting them on the Facebook page when you're at the events, trying to actually interact with listeners and things like that. Those are probably the biggest things that are important since you are supposed to be a spokeswoman for the radio station and the different shows. Otherwise, I would say being on air with Andy is a responsibility since that's kind of a huge selling point for being the Rock Girl. And just making sure that you put out a good face for all the listeners and everybody, promote the page and the radio station appropriately, but also in a really fun way. So those of you who are interested in potentially auditioning, going to a casting call, even if you don't feel like you're the right girl for the part, even if you're not a Rock Girl currently, that doesn't make any difference. It doesn't matter if you have all the tattoos and the crazy hair and you wear the outfits that you would anticipate a Rock Girl wearing. I definitely didn't think that I was the Rock Girl material. I don't know music as well as I know other girls do. I don't have the connections to musicians and people in the industry like other girls do. I don't have the super crazy hair or anything like that, and I don't have, you know, the outrageous lifestyle or anything like that. So definitely had my own doubts, and look where I am now. So I also had a crazy busy schedule, and that still worked. So one of the biggest questions that I've been getting from people is the time commitment, and I would say it's flexible. If you have other things going on, it's going to be considered, and so I don't even want you to have the time commitment be something that prevents you from auditioning. I love being the Rock Girl. It's definitely bittersweet to hand it off to someone else, but I think that this was an amazing opportunity for me. I completely came out of my shell, and I've done things that I never would have been able to or even considered the opportunity to do otherwise. So I'm very grateful to everybody who voted for me and everybody who came to the events and everybody who still comes to events and, of course, all the Lazer staff and everybody. So I think that this was a huge turning point for me. So as silly as that sounds, since I'm just a spokeswoman and I won a contest, it really can be a life-changing thing if you really put yourself out there. If you have any questions or anything that you want me to chit-chat with you about regarding the Rock Girl search or the casting calls or anything that I do as the Rock Girl, you have any other questions, just go ahead and message me on the Lazer Rock Girl Facebook page. Hey, it's Rock Girl Sydney. If you like that video, make sure to subscribe to our channel.